everyone, it's Cece, and I just want to let you know, natural light only, oh, there's an overhead light, you can see it in the TV right there. But today I'm going to do a what's in my bag. I got one thing from the Nordstrom anniversary sale. My bag's right here. Just one thing. And I had been looking for a purse for the summer, really, and I haven't found one. For the past couple years, found some at like Kohl's and Target, but I've really had a problem with them. Like my jeans will rub off on them, and I just don't want to deal with that. So I still haven't found a better purse. They don't have to be too expensive, but I do know that the Nordstrom anniversary sale gives you about 40% off. So this was the purse that I was using all summer, and I've been using it. I guess it's 2 years ago I got it at the Nordstrom anniversary sale, and it's the Rebecca Minkoff 5-zip, I believe, even though there's only four, and these move back and forth. These have absolutely no pockets in them, but the top one does, and it will fit my iPhone 6S Plus, and this is the inside. The only pocket it has is this open pocket right here, and can't stick much in there really. So this is it. It's the kind of gunmetal chain. It has studs on it, and I love this, and I would still wear it. It's still in great condition, but I did want something different, and this Saturday I changed into my fall purse. The weather is starting to get fall here in the Midwest. Not quite. It's going to be 80 today and in the 80s all week. And then I saw like a 69 temperature too. So, you know, it can be whatever. The makeup look that I have on, I just did a get ready with me and it was published on Monday. Okay. Same shirt too. Sorry. Same shirt. I have a couple different styles of shirts that look very similar that I wear in the house all the time. So this is, I'll show you the dust bag first, is a Vince Camuto. I've never had anything Vince Camuto, although I know it's a popular brand at Nordstrom. I really wanted the booties that match this, and I just never got them. Really, really wanted them. So this is also a crossbody, but more of like a satchel. And it's in the color, I think like Volcano or something. But it's more of like a satchel, and the front flap is a gray suede, deep gray, and then the rest of the body of the purse is a pebbled leather. It has a chain with adjustable spots, and it has a deep back pocket, which definitely fits my iPhone. Currently I have just a couple samples of hand cream in there that I'd like to put in my desk at work. So there's this. It's very soft. It's sturdy, but it's got a very soft touch to it. So it's a really nice purse. It also came in a burgundy color and a tan color. I have a burgundy purse, otherwise I probably would have got this. The inside is also lined in a suede type fabric, but not as hefty of a suede as the flap. It has this beautiful detail in it, laser cut, stitching. So it's a satchel type bag. And I'll tell you that this bag, although it looks much bigger than the Rebecca Minkoff, holds the same stuff. So this is basically what I keep in my bag. I didn't really put anything extra in here. And I'm going to show you the inside, and then we'll repack it up, hopefully a little nicer than it was. So this bag actually has a zip pocket inside, which I love comparatively. And I just keep like some glass wipes in there. There's some like allergy pills, some bobby pins, some Band-Aids. You know, sometimes there will be the feminine supplies, whoops. And then this one also has, which I love, two front pockets that are open. And in those, in the bigger one, I'm going to keep my Beauty Blender Blazzarotti Pro. That just kind of goes in there nice and just lays in there really nice. And then I have an Advil little container and a pen. I love these pens. They're Paper Mate. Not too expensive. I think they give a little bit of money to breast cancer research. And this is my Kate Spade wallet. It's, I don't remember what it's called, but it's fairly simple. But it holds quite a bit. There's my new driver's license back there. But here's my like store cards, gift cards, Sephora cards, Ulta card, YMCA card, bank card, another gift cards, anything that I might need there. And then I have some pockets full with like coupons and things like that. And it does have a change receptacle on the back. And this has this blue and black print. Also very soft. I've had this 2 years. I got this at the Nordstrom anniversary sale 2 years ago. And I would say it's in perfect, very good condition. Maybe not perfect. The only thing I don't like about it, and I like about it, is it has this bow, which for a small wallet just takes up that much more room in my purse. Which is super cute, but it takes up room. I have an old change purse from Coach. There's not a whole lot of change in there. It's an old one. It matches a lining on one of my other purses. So I just kind of like to set that in there. And then next are the beauty items, and that's really it. I keep a Real Techniques kind of like compact brush to go. Really nice. Very easy to kind of take care of. So I kind of keep that like in a corner somewhere. And then I usually have some sort of this sample size of a makeup setting spray, hydration water, something like this. And this is from her First Aid Beauty Vitamin Hydration Mist. So that kind of goes in a corner too as well. And then this is a little Kat Von D pouch I got with like a 500 point reward from Sephora. And I have my lipstick of the day in there, which is Salt Life from Tarte currently. That's what I'm wearing now. I also keep for that little Real Techniques brush. Oh my gosh, this is a mess. Bye Bye Pores Pressed. It was a little sample size. And I definitely use that like at work, you know, once a day. I have a Cabana Girl lip gloss from Philosophy. Love to have those in there. You just never know. I keep a liner. This one is from Jordana and it's in 20. Just keep a liner in there. And a tiny little like button size mirror from Sephora. And so not a whole lot of makeup. The Blazzarotti is very important. I keep that in there. Wherever I can. I'm in that a lot, whether I'm out or at work. And the entire inside is lined in that light gray suede. And I think that's really it with this. It has a little bit of, I guess, the same metal as that Rebecca Minkoff. A little bit there. Has a little tag with Vince Camuto on it and another just like piece of leather here hanging. And then I use it as a crossbody and I guess I could show you that as well. Just have a longish body, so I do have it on the longest length. And then when I'm done with my keys or whatever, I always like to snap them on like this. So I will have like a gray pom-pom or something keychain for that as well. And it just hangs right at my hip. I like the length that it's at. It could go up a little bit more, but I like kind of the length that it's at. And so I guess that's it. If you have any questions about this, I think, is my receipt? My receipt's not in there. I think I paid like $169 for it, and it was like $250 originally, or something like that. But so far I really like it. I did spray the suede with a waterproofer a couple times, just to try to keep that nice, because I'm pretty much against suede purses in general, but I really like this one, and really it was the only one that I liked in store. Usually a suede purse, like, you know, the seams and stuff will really wear down quickly. So, and at work in my drawer, I just keep like an old dust bag, and I just put this in there so that it's kind of protected if things get moved around or whatever. If you have any questions about this, please let me know. I'll try to answer them for you. And like I said, it's the only thing I picked up at the Nordstrom anniversary sale, but it's something I love already. And I just changed into it Saturday because we had kind of like a little family dinner that we went to. And I kind of just wanted to be like new, something new for that, you know? But yeah, let me know. I don't keep a whole lot in there, but it's still pretty heavy. I used to have like the satchel. Maybe that's not a satchel. I don't remember. Darn it. But I guess the satchel type bags is what I used to carry. And I used to stuff them full of, you know, everything. And now it's just easier to have something that's crossbody for, you know, when you're going shopping. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to worry about anybody coming, you know, to get it. You can always put the flap on the inside. It just makes it a lot easier. So it's something that I've come to really enjoy it in the last few years, and kind of like just pare down everything. Because I used to keep like 30 lipsticks in my purse. Who needs that? Do you? No, probably not. But I keep today's lipstick in there, and that's really it. Sometimes there's two. That little pouch can fit two lipsticks. I just took the other one out because I know I'll be wearing this one today. But other than that, really? That's what I used to do. Oh. So please just say hi, like this video if you can, subscribe. Love talking to you guys. I think maybe my next video might be something like a tour over here of how and where I keep my makeup. I feel like it's starting to get cluttered, and I'm probably going to do a little bit of a declutter very soon. I've gotten rid of a couple things, but a couple more things could go, I'm sure. So, hopefully, maybe give this a thumbs up or say that you'd like to see that. And I'll work on that. I think next week, maybe even this week, maybe I'll do the declutter this week and then I can do the video next week real quick for you. Thanks so much. I'm so glad you're here on my channel, and I really appreciate the support you've given me. And I'm also going to do a Bath & Body Works candle haul eventually. That might be in a couple weeks. So thank you so much. I love interacting with anybody in the comments, so please do that as well. Bye, have a great day.